From KETK, you're watching East Texas Live at 3.
Welcome back to East Texas Live here on KETK. Joining us now is Mike with Team Sight Magazine, and he's here to tell us about the new and innovative high-tech gear softball players use. Thank you so much for being here
today. It's a pleasure.
Yes, sir.
I'm on my way to Oklahoma City for the Women's College World Series. It's the 33rd year it's gone to Oklahoma City. I think there's about 115,000 fans expected, and they'll be seeing all these great athletes playing with this kind of gear and others. The high tech has really influenced the creation of softball gear, and it all sort of starts with a batting glove. Mizuno's got a glove. It's the Finch, named after Jenny Finch, the U.S. Olympic pitcher. This glove actually has breathability mesh in the back of the hand that allows air to go in there to add comfort. You also have reinforcements in the padding. It acts as a shock absorber as well as creates more comfort and longevity, giving you a better bang for your buck. And of course, it's got a nice strap to keep it all in place. And that's from Mizuno. If you're going to bat, you've got to have a batting helmet. A lot of great brands out there, whether it's Rippet or Easton or Wilson or Rawlings. This specific brand from Rippet actually has 21 aerodynamic holes strategically placed. I did count them. It is 21. That keeps your head cool. You also have some wicking abilities here within the double padding that add comfort. Another big thing is you have better visibility, both peripheral vision and looking out, because once you're on base, you're still going to keep this helmet on, so you need to keep an eye on the fielders and the ball and where it's hit and stuff like that. Very lightweight, and again, lots of great brands out there to keep you safe. Gloves. I saw your eye just a few minutes ago. This glove is part of the A2000 glove from Wilson. Big story is that the finger areas, the finger ports are designed for the female hand as well as the wrist closure. And then this glove actually has an expanded area for the ball to go into, because the softball is bigger than the baseball. Makes it easier to take the ball out of your glove and to make those double plays. As far as the construction, this is actually made of what they call super skin leather. It's half the weight of traditional leather and also is twice as durable, so it lasts twice as long. And this is part of the A2000 series from Wilson. One thing about this glove, that's designed for the older girl, the adult. This is a glove from Rawlings for the younger child. So the smaller the athlete, the smaller the hand, the smaller the equipment. So the gear has been designed to grow with the athlete. So,
yes, sir.
Yeah.
And what kind of improvements have you seen with the bats?
Well, the bats are lighter, stronger, more durable. Some people make a comment about them being rather expensive, but you're going to get a great bang for your buck, though. They have a long longevity. This is a brand from DeMarini. We also have an Easton bat here. There's also great bats from Mizuno and of course, Easton's got a ton of bats that you'll see on display at Oklahoma City. This particular bat is a two-compression bat. There's an inner wall and an outer wall as far as the barrel. But the big premise here is that the weight is distributed throughout the bat. A traditional wooden baseball bat, most of the weight is in the barrel. It's a little more difficult to control. But with the metal mat or the non-wood bat, the weight is distributed fairly equally throughout the bat, so you can actually... You can control the bat. The bat doesn't control you, so you have a better chance of hitting the ball, getting a base hit, getting on, and maybe scoring a run and having it exciting. So the technology has been revolutionary, and how the bats have changed the last 15, 20 years is pretty amazing.
Yes, sir. And just how has the women's uniforms kind of changed over the years?
Everything is actually being geared more to the female body. Years ago, everything was made for boys, and the phrase was for girls, shrink it or pink it. And so now actually everything is, because the female body is designed a little differently than the male body, so it's a better fit, there's more fashion involved, they're lighter, more comfortable, everything's better, and the young ladies wearing these things, they look like real athletes. So it's good that the industry has recognized that and caters to them.
Yes, sir. Mike, well, thank you so much for coming in and telling us all about these new and improved equipment.
It's getting better every year.
Yes, sir. All right. More information on this equipment, you can go to the website right here on your screen.